So we're live. What are we in? We're March 5th, 2019, 12 p.m. Pacific time, Pacific Western Canada time, right? PST. And welcome to another live stream. I'm Chicho, and what we're gonna make today is borscht. I grabbed my mom's borscht recipe. Okay. I'll show it to you. Over the phone, I wrote it down on stickies, okay? And I've eaten that a lot, right? And I know what it's supposed to taste like. I've seen her make it, and I've made different types of stews based on what I've seen and experimentation and stuff, but I've never made her full-blown borscht recipe, and that's what we're gonna do today, okay? Aside from that, we're going to wait a couple of minutes for people to start rolling in, but we're going to get going pretty fast on this, okay? The reason being is we need to get the meat boiling away, cooked in water, right, to make the broth. Gong, how are you doing? Welcome to a stream. I've been looking forward to the stream, man. I've been craving since we decided to make borscht. I've been craving to eat borscht from that day. I can barely hear you, man. Oh, really? It's really low. Here, let me see what my volume is at here. My gain. It should be okay. I start talking louder and louder as the cooking streams begin. Can you check to see if it's your end? Hello, Nicholas. How are you doing? I went and got all the colleagues. I might have time this week to set up the reading stuff, to read one, two of the comics and do a comic book video, okay? Fun. We paid some fair price, some pretty good price, and some ridiculously, like, I went to pick up the comics and the comic book owner's like shaking his head. It's like, what? You'll be happy. I was very happy. You'll be happy. Okay. I hope the sound is okay. Let me give you lay of the land. Awesome, bro. Looking forward to it. So more fun. It's good. So, by the way, Nicholas, there's two comics. Hello, X. How are you doing? But Nicholas, hello, comic book Jedi. Quick question. I got in the hall. There's a romance comic, Golden Age romance comic, we're going to take a look at, most likely two of them, okay? But there are other types of comics. If we do a reading, if we end up doing more than one reading, what comic book reading would you like? There's a superhero one, there's a couple of romance ones, there's a war comic book one, there's some just zany, weird comic books, I think, anyway, if I remember correctly. What kind of comic books would you, or stories would you like to have a read of? And if they're in the hall, I'll pick one and we'll do a reading of that, okay? Aside from that, gang, welcome to another live stream. War would be good, bro. Awesome. We're gonna do, as a request, we have a Golden Age war comic that I picked up. I think it's Golden Age anyway, 1950s. Okay, we'll have a read through that as well. Okay. So aside from that, I want to get the ball rolling here. We got that because I need the meat to be cooked, right? And in a pressure cooker, it's supposed to take an hour, but I haven't set up the pressure cooker. I just got a regular pot. It's supposed to take 2 hours, but I'm going to kick up the heat a notch, right? So as before, we've got our two cameras set up here. Camera, computer coming this way. And I got the sound set up here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do right now is just rinse the meat, and let me turn on these. Boop. Okay, so we got the pot here, okay, and we're gonna do a lot of chopping and stuff on this here. Chicho, hello Connor, how are you doing? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rinse the meat, okay, and then put it in the pot. So let me show you what we ended up getting. Eduardo, how's life? I like the Brazilian bossa nova that you posted on Discord. Not fun music, man. Fun music. I gotta put on my glasses to read this. Cooking stream. I need a cooking hat, eh? So I picked up 0.6 kilos of beef shank, okay? Tender cut. And this is like organic stuff I pick up. Just so you know what I'm putting in the meat, okay? I don't know if you can read that. Beef shank. And it costs like $13 basically, right? So about 0.6 kilos cost about $13, right? And I picked up 3 cuts of beef short ribs. And this is organically, locally grown as well. And this one cost, again, 0.6 per, I picked up 0.6 kilos of it and ended up costing like $17 or something, right? So that's the meat that we're going to be using. Just so you know, because it's pretty important to know what type of meat is going in there. And I'm picked up some stuff that has bone in it, right? I'll show it to you. So that way a bone marrow goes into the soup, into the broth, as well as a little bit of fat, because you do need a little bit of fat in this thing as well. Okay. So let me crank these open. And this is the pot that we're going to use to just put the meat in there. We're going to put water and we're going to put salt and we're going to cook it up, right? So I'm just going to give the meat a rinse, put it in here. I'll show you what the meat looks like, and then we're going to not fill it up with water, but give it a fair bit of water, about, you know, this much handful above the meat, right? Because you want the borscht to be, it's a soup, right? So you do want it to be a little liquid. So let me do this. Here, I'm going to bring this guy over here when I'm giving you a rinse, I got a plastic bag. When I take out meats and stuff, I usually take the bags that they were in and I put them in a plastic bag and I put them in the freezer just to store, because our garbage comes once every 2 weeks, right? So I don't want the, you know, for the garbage can to be smelly, right? And then after 2 weeks, you put them in the garbage and throw them. Here, let me show you what this looks like before I rinse it. This is what the shank is, right? And it's got the bone part in there, right? Not bad. Nice amount of fat on there as well, right? And then when the borscht cools down the next day, because this is going to be enough borscht to eat for 3 days, 3 or 4 days, we're going to have borscht, right? Show you what the beef short ribs look like. And borscht is, I usually use lamb. I like lamb. It's rare that I buy beef, but with borscht, you want beef. Okay. So this is the short ribs. So it has bone in there. Fatty as well. And there's 3 pieces here. And there's another piece over there. So 3 pieces. The middle one was the big one. Here's the other piece. So about 1.2 kilos of beef meat. just crush up the paper so it doesn't take too much space. And throw this. Close it up and throw in the freezer. Okay. Show you what the meat, how much it filled up the bottom, so you see exactly how much meat we're using. And then I got most of the ingredients back here that I'll show you. When did your interest in cooking start? I'll tell you when. Let me show you the meat. Let's get the water boiling on this. So this is how much meat we're using, right? Okay. Actually, you can see it way better here. Cool. Okay, I'm gonna fill it up. Make sure the meat is covered, plus about a handful more. Okay, so let me fill it up and see how much we get in. So it's not actually a handful, it's about, if you can see that, so it's about, I would be three fingers above the meat, all flat on the bottom. Okay, now I'm going to kick this up. I'm going to put this on 6 out of 9, because the rest of what we're about to do, I gotta add salt. So let me add a little salt to this too before we forget. Okay, now salt with my stews and stuff, I just go by sight. I just do this sprinkle up top, right? But we're gonna do it with teaspoon wise, because we should be doing a tablespoon wise. So let's do a tablespoon. And this is actually, we have the measuring cups here. Should we use measuring cups? Let's see, what does this say? Let's see what this says. This is, I think it says 1/8 of a cup. We'll check it out. This is 1/8 of a cup. So I'm going to use 1/8 of a cup and see if that. Let me take off a little specks. See? Get rid of that guy. So let's use 1/8 of a cup. Okay. Let's see if that's too much. I'm going to use a little bit more. It wasn't all the way to the top. So let's say we put 1/8 of a cup of salt. I might add more later when the broth is, you know, it's nicely cooked. Okay. And I'm putting the temperature at right now, 6 out of 9. As for your question, Nicholas, when, like I really learned how to cook university. We had to, one of the, there's, it's multi-phase, I guess. I should answer it that way, I guess. When I really learned how to cook was about 15 years ago or so, when I apprenticed under my mom for about 5 years. Okay. And the reason I did that was because I wanted to learn how to make this Armenian pastry that It's like the Armenian pastry, and it is amazing. Intrepid, how are you doing? Hey, Chicho. Wish I could stay for the stream. It sounds delicious. Hope you're having a good day, brother. Having a fantastic day. Very looking forward to making borscht, right? Thanks for popping by the way. Thanks for popping by. So I apprenticed under my mom for about 5 years, right? Because I wanted to learn how to make this pastry, and pastry is very intricate, and this pastry is intricate, right? And during that time, we ended up cooking a lot. We're living in the same house, right? So she was cooking a lot, and I was cooking with her, and so I learned a lot, right? That was the main push for me, where I really learned how to cook well, right? Before that, at university, for part of it, I was living by myself or with others, roommates, one bedroom apartment, three people living on tile flooring, in a sleeping bag for a couple of years and stuff like this. You're limited on fun, so you can't eat out all the time. So I learned how to cook there a little bit. But the first cooking I ever did that I really took care of myself was when I was in elementary school. And I loved eating eggs. I'll give you like deep info, right? Student days for me were packets of ramen noodle. I used to eat love submarines. If there was a place that had sales and subs, and you could buy, check this out, you could buy five subs for $10, right? And there's times where I didn't have money, and I would have to go get emergency loan from the university and stuff like this. And if a loan came through, like $100 to pay for food for a month or something like this, right? When the funds came in, I would go buy five subs, right? But the first time that I really cooked for myself was in elementary school, because I loved eating eggs. Just to answer your question, Nick, let's go a little deeper. I loved eating eggs, and my parents weren't feeding me eggs every day. So I would get up before they would, before school, and I would go to the kitchen. I'd be like in grade 5 or 6 or something like this, and cook eggs for myself before people woke up, and I would eat eggs. Okay. I just like food, man. Food is amazing. It's one of the greatest pleasures in life. Let me show you the ingredients, what we're gonna do. Okay, we're gonna use white cabbage. Okay, I've already cleaned, washed everything, right? This one we're gonna chop up, but I'm gonna give it a rinse as well once we chop it up. Okay, we got beets. Now I'm not sure, the cabbage we're gonna use all of it most likely. Okay, the beets, I don't think I'm gonna use all of it. Here, let me show you here. So I got five beets here already cleaned up. Okay. Good, good, good. I can hear this, the heat going through it, right? So keep it on six. So I got five beets here. The odds are we're probably gonna use like three of them. Okay. I'm guessing you froze the subs to keep the week. I appreciate hearing the deeper answer. Actually, I didn't. I would like, if I needed emergency funding from school, really, I was no money, right? So I was eating bread or rice or whatever, right? So when I went and got five subs, I would usually eat three of them in one day and two the next day. We got tomatoes, nice tomatoes. Red peppers, I guess yellow or orange peppers. And from what I understand, peppers, the color is just as they ripen more, right? So red peppers are easier on the tummy, I believe. What's up, everyone? Cenk, how you doing? What's up, Chicho? Hope everyone's Big Tuesday is going well. Yeah, Big Tuesday. It's phenomenal weather, by the way, in my part of the world. It's like sunny, cold, but sunny. It's like, wow, great break. We got potatoes. Okay. And I've already washed some carrots. We're not going to use all of them, but I've already washed them and cleaned up a little bit. I might clean them up a little bit more. Do you want any spice that we're going to use? Is salt? Okay. And we got bay leaves. Just bay leaves that we've picked ourselves, either from a tree or from a bush. Okay. We have lots of bay leaf. There's bay leaf trees that we have. One of our relatives has a bay leaf tree, so we just go and pick the bay leaves. And we know friends and stuff that have bushes that are like bay leaves. So just dried bay leaves that we picked ourselves. Aside from that, I'm gonna start doing some chopping. I should be able to read a fair bit of comments if you guys want to talk about whatever. I got myself some of the lemon liqueur. Okay. Trusted tea. I got my tea going here as well. And I've already chopped up some greens, herbs, and stuff that when we make the borscht, usually eat it either with yogurt or sour cream, and then a little bit of parsley and cilantro and stuff up top that you mix it together. Some people like putting lemon on it. And we have, I went and got some dark, heavy rye bread. And with borscht, you want heavy bread, like dark bread, right? And flatbread is good too, because when you take out the meat, you can make sandwiches. But one of the ideal things that goes with borscht is biryani. It's like dumplings, deep fried dumplings that have either potatoes in them or sort of a hamburger style ground beef mix with eggs and stuff. I don't know how to make that. I've never made it. I've watched grandma, mom, aunts and stuff make it, but I will get the recipe and I want to learn how to make that as well. Okay, I know the dough. I've never made it, right? I've helped out, but haven't done it. Okay, so I need to talk to my mom and figure out how to do it. It ain't a Chicho stream without off-screen gear. Fun. Let's chop up the cabbage first, okay? Because I do want to give it a rinse, and I'm gonna chop all of it up, okay? So let me put these guys in here so they're out of the way, so the sink is not tied up. You guys having a good day? You can feel the, well, in my part of the world, you can feel the end of winter coming. Everyone's really excited about summer kicking in, or spring kicking in at least. I'm gonna wear my apron. We got beets that we had need to chop up, and beet stain. Eduardo, what are you exactly working on related to math? How so? What do you mean, Eduardo? Like, in my, as my life as a geophysicist, when I was doing geophysics, or right now? Right now, I'm just teaching, right? Cut this up. We're gonna take this part out. Have you ever eaten Romanian mici? I could eat that stuff. No, I've never had. Is that like a dumpling or a soup? Cabbage just falls apart. I got a little compost thing set up. Right now, do you plan on bringing more math content to the channel? Oh, for sure, Eduardo, for sure, 100%. I have some. I've been meaning to do. It's just I've made a lot of promises over the last few years to do things that some people are. When I make a promise to people on regarding content on the channel, some people recommend to do things, and I say, "Oh, that sounds great." If I don't do it within a few months, you know, send me a reminder, and we'll get it done. So I've had a lot of promises come back to me, which I'm okay with, right? But for sure, the math content is has reduced a little bit. Just on that note, okay. And there will be math coming. I have within the next couple of months, I'm gonna go pretty heavy on the math, And in the summer times, I usually go fairly heavy on the math because it's just the time that I'm not teaching and I like mathematics in my life, so it's fun thinking about the problems and the puzzles. But just on that note, on the mathematics front, I finally ended up editing the live stream of the 10 by 10 puzzle that we made, the three streams the same day. And I've already loaded it on YouTube, and I think after the stream, most likely today, if not today, then tomorrow, I'm gonna release almost a 3 hour stream of us playing three 10 by 10 math games that we did. Oh, that's the Romanian mishi. Sausages made from ground beef mixed with spices and beef broth. Oh, that sounds yummy. Eastern European, just sausages. Let me put this out here so we can put it all in. I'm just gonna put the cabbages in this, and then once we got it all chopped up, I'm gonna put it in the sink and just run water over it, okay? Let's put this here. Yeah, the math content, Eduardo, it's one thing with the math content, once I start doing it, I just get immersed in it, right? I just want to do more and more and more. So before I really delve down into it, I need to clear off my plate of a few videos I've been meaning to make. That includes some of the comic book stuff that I've really been behind on doing. So there's going to be a bunch of comic book stuff coming. Once we're done with the comic book stuff, then I think we're going to delve deep into the mathematics. I have some stuff laid out that I want to do regarding just looking at data. Very simple, just looking at data and trying to figure out how you can interpret the data. One of the data sets I want to use is IMDb's movie ratings, right? I find that extremely fascinating because sometimes, I'm not sure if you guys use IMDb just to see, what the ratings of movies are, but the way I use IMDb is I just don't look at the rating that they present. That sounds very interesting. Yeah. I don't look at the rating that they just present, right? That's the first thing I see because that's their pushing button. And then I read user comments. Okay. And then what I do is click on the link that they have. It's a hyperlink that they have for the rating, and they break it down into age group, male, female, top 1,000. I guess users and whatnot, right? And the discrepancy between the different categories of ratings that they have are crazy. And IMDb rating, if you click on the rating that they have, okay. Boss, last time I was around, we were talking politics, and this time cooking. Awesome game. Yeah, we move it around a fair bit. We might be doing the comic books. Well, no, what are we doing gonna do next? I haven't planned what we're gonna do next in terms of the live stream. There's a couple of videos I need to shoot. They're related to Nicholas comic books. So, and maybe a math one that I wanted to do, an off math one. But if you click on the IMDb rating, at the top, there's a sentence that says they're not, the rating is proprietary. It's not really the mean or the average or this. They're giving it some kind of ranking system themselves. They have an internal algorithm running in the background, which is not necessarily always the same as the mean, right? And sometimes the discrepancy is pretty large. I've been building up a database of movies that I've come across that I disagree with either their rating or their rating is way different than their mean. Yeah, Metacritic does that for games too. IMDb review and now analytics are very in-depth. Yeah, I like the IMDb's. I don't read all the reviews, but I look at some of the passionate ones, right? And it's cool. I like sometimes just go off and just read reviews of a movie that maybe I loved and they hated, or a movie that I hated that they loved, and or IMDb's given a rating of high, right? And you can read the reviews of people trash talking this thing, trash talking it, right? I remember you telling us to remind you about an anime stream last stream. Okay, cool. I gotta get the. I have to loop Space Dandy. I have to watch all of Space Dandy before I can do the anime video because I want to pick out the segment that I'm looking for. But thank you, Jink, for your reminder. Oh, it was King. You said do the anime video. Nice.
Maybe.
We'll let that sit. Now, let me just read a couple of comments that were posted. Not you, King. I forgot who mentioned it. Oh, okay. I do watch anime and go around asking people, but my memory is as good as the goldfish's. Okay, so let me get rid of this. Because I'm not sure if I was using all the stuff. It's okay to have the cabbages here too, but I'm not 100% sure if we're going to use up everything that I cut up. I might use those for something else because what we're going to do is cook the meat in this pot, right? And then transfer the meat here, okay? And then start putting ingredients in. And once it cooks a little bit, and then add the broth to it. So we can only use enough ingredients to fill this up, right? I have more than that. Take a look at the meat. Nice. So let me bring out, just a wooden spoon, right? I just want to give it a the meat's already changed colors, become brown. Once it cooks meat, it just becomes brownish, right? Nice. Actually, before I put this down, bring out a little. Let's do this. I'm just gonna bring this out and put the meaty spoon in it, right? That way we're not contaminating everything. Okay. And what I want to do now is I'm gonna kick this up. Now that it's heated up, I'm kicking it up to the temperature on this to 8 because I want to get it boiling. I want to get it hard boiling, right? Nice. Let that be there. So, let's do this. Let's chop up. We have onions to cut up too. But the onions we're gonna cut up at the end. Food Wars anime stream. Food Wars, that sounds familiar. I think I've seen that. Or am I thinking Fooly Cooly? I don't know if you guys have seen Fooly Cooly. Fooly Cooly is fantastic. Very trippy. Let's cut up the carrots. Let's cut up some carrots. And carrots, when you wash them, they get a little, what do you call it? I skinned a little bit, cleaned them up a little bit. Food Wars is interesting to say the least. Yeah, I haven't watched that forever. I'm pretty sure I'm thinking about, how many should we use? Let's use 5 carrots. 5 carrots is good. Shego no Mosa, Food Wars. Maybe. Cool. I gotta look it up. There's a lot lot of amazing anime out there, right? This is good. Let me just give them a rinse, and then we'll bring it back here and chop it up. Stews, I like, you know, multiple sizes of carrots and stuff, right? Sometimes you get a big chunk, sometimes you get a little guy, right? It gives a good flavor. And these guys, yeah, we'll put the beets in the carrots. So I'm just gonna put the carrots in this, okay? Or chop some of the stuff that we've chopped up, okay? The carrots and the beets and stuff, we'll put in there. Actually, beets we'll put in a separate thing, maybe on top, because I want the beets, once we layer the things, I want the beets to be lower down in the pot, and the other pot that we're going to cook things in. Okay. Nice. Now I'm going to kick this up to high. Okay. The maximum. Let the heat kick up. All the carrots. We're gonna use all the carrots. Here, let me show you how much carrots we got. Wait, I'm not kidding. Right. We got this much carrots. Okay. We're gonna use all this. Probably not all of it. Okay. So I'm gonna leave this on the side. We can chop up the beets and put it up on top of the carrots, which is fine, because later on what I might do is either freeze these or keep them in the fridge for like 3 or 4 days and then use them again once we finish all the borscht that we're eating, right? Let's cut up the beets. Let's cut up the potatoes first. Because the potatoes, I want to chop some of it really fine. Once we add the broth and stuff, I want to add really chopped up fine potatoes in the soup with all the ingredients, because that will give it a little bit of thickness. Okay, it'll seep out a little bit of the starch, right? So let's just cut these guys up. And these look like good beets. Chunks, and you can chop it up finer as well, which I'm about to do in a little bit. We're probably going to use up 3 beets. Okay. That sounds good, but let's do three beats. We need lots of beats in Borscht. I'm gonna scrape some of the gook up. Let's bring this out. Let's bring this out. And that's one thing you end up doing when you're either slow cooking meat. Three. We don't beat around the bush. Yeah, three beats we will. So whenever you're boiling meat or slow cooking bones and stuff like this, you get gook on top. So I'm gonna take these guys off. This one's giving out a fair bit. I usually buy bones from this butcher, and you don't get that much. Okay. And when I'm doing making bone broth, I add apple cider vinegar that breaks down the nicely boiling. Now I'm gonna kick it down to around, let's make it 8. Okay, give it a little stir. Apple cider vinegar in bone broth is really good. Gets all the minerals down, minerals out of the bones and stuff like this. This many carrots, that many beets, three beets for sure. And we're gonna use that many carrots. So let me transfer these guys over. We'll do one more beet. Right? Let me transfer it over. Carrots are also good in Borscht. Let's do one more beat.
Yeah.
Let's kick it down a little bit. And that's one of the things that happens, right? It bubbles up and spills. Oh, look at that. See the bubbles? The foam. Let's take out some of the gook again. Hopefully it's not going to bubble up. I might kick it down. I'm kicking it down a little bit, kicking it to 7. Okay. So we've probably been going for half an hour, right? I think anyway, for the water boiling, let's say 20 minutes. I'm going to put the timer on another 40 minutes. Might as well keep track of it through time, right? Have a timer going off. When I do cooking, timer is my friend. Okay. So I put the timer on 40 minutes. That means we're going to cook this thing for about an hour. According to the recipe my mom was giving me, you got to cook it for an hour in the pressure cooker, or 2 hours on the stove. You might cook it longer. We'll take a look. Definitely gonna have downtime when we're cooking this Borscht up. So check this out. Get my hands on this. carrots and beets. Now that's a fair bit of ingredients for this, right? You know what? It does reduce. We'll leave it like this for now. Let's cook up the red peppers and the orange peppers. And before we do that, let's have a sip. Clean up some of the gook from the side of a pot, right? Which is something that I do. That way we know it's not going to be entering the broth when we transfer it over. Let's do this. Let's give this a little rinse. Now I'm going to cut up the yellow and red peppers. I've already washed them. They're beautiful. And we're just gonna put them on top of the beets in the same bowl. Keep an eye on this thing, right? Once it boils up a few times, when it rises up, it does it less so a little bit. You get rid of some of the gook and keep an eye on it. You get a feel for what's going on to a certain degree. Right, chat, got to go. Have a good day, Nicholas. Thanks for popping by. Chicho, catch you next time, bro. Have a great stream. Looks delicious so far. Looks delicious so far. And the smell of the meat is pretty good. With the salt and. When you get good quality meat, it's just. It's nice. It's nice. Let's cut these up. Let's get rid of these guys. The little fluff. Cut these up, and these ones I don't chop up too thin. Okay, for my stews anyway, the instructions were don't chop them up too thin. Some long ones, some half long ones. Let's get rid of this part. I'll probably do a few different sizes on them. like anything, if it's the first time cooking, you do end up adjusting the recipe. So we'll see what we do next time. Maybe we won't touch it, maybe we'll like everything about it. Chicho, a little off topic, but do you have any beard growing tips? Beard growing tips. To help you grow a beard, or to help you deal with the aftermath of having a beard? Because it can be tricky in this society. You have to have a full-blown beard, or used to be anyway. There was times where I grew full beards and it didn't go over well where I was around. As far as what to do to help grow a beard, I think food is it. I keep on coming back to the same thing, right? Hi, Grandpa. Hello, my child. How are you doing? Do you know how to cook borscht? Borscht is delicious. Good ingredients. So I think food has a lot to do with it, if you can grow a beard, full beard or not. So, you know, I haven't done the research into this. I just genetically, it's just worked out for me, right? So I'm sorry, I wasn't someone that had a hard time growing a beard. I was just able to grow a beard. I just made fresh onion soup. Oh, awesome. Fresh onion soup's fantastic. I've mostly been told to moisturize the jawline and that shaving to grow faster is a myth. I don't know about that. Shaving to grow faster is a myth. I don't know. I know that's one thing I was told as well. But for me, you know, I had a mustache in high school. And I don't know if it's a myth or not. Like, the first time I ever shaved my mustache, it was in my early 20s or mid-20s or something. Believe it or not, crazy, eh? So I would shave this, but I hadn't shaved this for a very long time. So I'm not sure what the situation would be. Here's our peppers. Okay. I cut up all the red and half the orange. This one we're not going to use up. What we got there is enough. So I'm going to put this one in a container and just throw it in the fridge. Okay. That way it's there for us to use later. Yeah, I just graduated from high school and I had a facial hair dress code. So I kind of became a werewolf upon entering college. Awesome. Oh, so they wouldn't let you have facial hair. Crazy, eh? Weird world. Weird world. And man, it's a different life if you have facial hair and if you don't have facial hair. It's nice and sunny, eh? Like the experiences, yeah, no facial hair and no hair past the ears, really. Now I have some Vice City. Nice. Crazy. So it must have been a private school. Yeah. I went to a private school, but they left us alone. This is many moons ago, right? Many moons ago.
tomatoes. Let's cut up the tomatoes.
We'll cut up the tomatoes as well. Nice. Look at that boiling, curdling. Yeah, that's what we want. Okay. Here, let me give it a little. That's good. It might require a little bit more. We leave it alone. Very strict, but I taught me this. It taught you discipline, yeah. That's one thing, to a certain degree. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. As long as you realize that you don't have to follow authority always, right? For us, part of my high school life was private. And it was a pretty lax private school. But there were good people there and bad people there, right? So discipline with love is good. Discipline out of malice is not good. And unfortunately, some people take their power a little bit too far, right? Oh, I'm not saying I followed the rules to the T. Yeah, either did we. But they were there if they needed it, right? If they needed to put you in your place, they definitely did. They definitely did. But the, just so you know, the private school system here, the discipline here, I need studying a discipline, Eduardo. Yeah, the discipline is, I think it comes and goes. We procrastinate, I think, much more in our youth, or I do anyway. I don't procrastinate anymore. It's weird. I stop procrastinating. I just do. I don't know if it's related to, as one person came up here, me being a older grandpa, or just me having more things in my life that I love doing. Definitely same. Eduardo, high school taught me that I could finesse my way out of hard assignments through loopholes. College has taught me the opposite. They're both useful. If you can game the system, you game the system, right? Should we do one more tomato? Let's do one more tomato. How many did we do? 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. No. 2, 4, 6, 8. No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tomatoes this size. Okay, that's what I'm putting in. That's a lot of ingredients. I don't think I should be putting in this many ingredients. Last tomato we're not going to do. We're going to put this in the fridge. That's one of the problems I have when I make stews and stuff. I prep way too many ingredients in the pot. It gets crazy full. Right. So, on that note, let's put these two guys here. So we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna use. I'll probably use all 5. For each of the ingredients, and we'll see. We'll divide it out so we get enough of each one. Okay. I'm going to grab some food momentarily. I will be back in a little. Excited to see the marsh. Me too. Hope you enjoy the food, man. Hope you enjoy the food. Yeah, this is making me hungry as well. Kong says. I'm thinking it's shrimp lo mein for me. Adios for now, shrimp lo mein. One too, let's cut it up. Five tomatoes we're chopping up. Okay, we'll see how much of it we end up using, how much of it fits in the pot. And then after that, it's just waiting. Once you put all the ingredients together, then we can talk about more about anything you guys want. Just to grab them all and put them in our bowl. Definitely a lot of tomatoes. One thing we do make, or I do make, is delicious. I think I've shown you guys this before. It's taking chopped up tomatoes and putting feta cheese in with it and then squishing them up and eating it. I think we did that on one of the previous live streams. Okay. Here's the tomatoes. Chopped up. Renan. Hey, Chicho. Lurking at work. Awesome. Happy lurking, brother. Or sister. Lurking is fun. I do lurk on Twitch a little bit. Just downtime, right? It's nice to have something going on in the background. Suck up the. Usually I will take this and just give it a rinse. Actually, maybe I'll do that. Here's our. Just a little bit of water come down. Let's bring this here. Let's put this guy here. Let's give this guy a rinse. Back. Give these guys a little wipe to get rid of all the little things here that I've spilled over. Clean as we go. Make life easier. Make the cleanup easier anyway. Let's put it back. Chicho, on your daily basis, are you still learning math? In the last video, you were showing hard and specific math books, and you sounded excited. Yeah, I'm not. I'm only learning anything that I need to learn to be able to teach, right? So if a student comes to me and says, you know, if they have a stats. Stuff they want to work on and I don't know the stuff, I'll track down a book and read it and learn how to do it or watch videos and stuff like this. If it's a little intro of calculus that with random students I'm sort of doing but not really, I'm telling them a lot, or some random functions that we want to dig down into, sure, I do look them up. But actively learning mathematics now, no, not right now. At some point I will. Okay, I'm pretty sure I do want to, maybe in my retirement, if I reach the age of 75 or so, I'll sit down and start learning mathematics to keep the brain sharp, right? Or at a time when I'm on the down low, right? But actively, no, Those books, as I mentioned, they were I inherited. Okay. And I got into a conversation with someone in that video on YouTube. There's a little chat going on. And that person is Brazilian as well, by the way. Eduardo, I know you're, I'm pretty sure you're from Brazil. And that person that commented was Brazilian as well. And they mentioned that the books look like a lot of electrical engineering books, and they are. Okay. So I go in a little bit of detail. Yes, I am. Yeah. Read the conversations on the last video, the book video, that I had with someone. That'll give you more insight into the books. And we talked a little bit about World Cup as well. I went to the 94 World Cup. And I went and saw 11 games at the 94 World Cup when it was in the States. And I saw, I think, 5 out of 7 of the Brazil games, or 6 out of 7 of the Brazil games. I was there in July, on July 4th, when Brazil played the United States. Phenomenal game. United States did fantastic, man. Kudos to the US fans. They put on an amazing show, right? I was there for that, and I saw Brazil and Italy in the final, and I saw Brazil and Sweden in the semifinal. So I'm pretty sure it was a semifinal with Sweden. Let's chop up the potatoes. 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 How many potatoes are we gonna chop up? We need potatoes. Let's see, how much ingredients do we have? Is that all gonna fit in that pot? We'll try. They'll shrink down. Some of the math books that I showed, they were mine as well. Some of the physics as well, just because I did physics, geophysics, and mathematics at university, right? The 2024 one will be in North America as well. I'm excited to hopefully see some games. Awesome. Is it going to be US or US-Canada combination? I'm only 4 hours away from Kansas City, so if they hold games there, I'll be sure to go watch them. Oh man, you should. It was an amazing experience, the World Cup. And in 94 in the States, like crazy. The tickets were they weren't going for scalper prices. Anywhere else in the world, a World Cup final ticket would have cost you thousands of dollars, right? In 94, they released some last-minute tickets, and there were great seats. I mean, it's a US-Canada-Mexico combination at a bunch of different stadiums. Awesome, awesome. If I can, I'll go watch too. Maybe. Price might be out of range, but who knows? But at 94, initially I had 6 tickets. I think 4 first round, 2 second round, or 5 tickets, or something like this, that we bought a year ahead of time, right? And then when I was in San Francisco, I wanted to see as many games as possible. I took time off, especially for it. It was a special World Cup for me. And they released some tickets, so I ended up buying tickets. And the face value of the final tickets was like $300, $400 US. That's how much they were selling it for, $500 US. And that's what I paid for. They weren't going for scalper prices. Right? Fantastic. Fantastic. Let's throw here. We'll put the potatoes here. I'll add these potatoes to these guys. I'm going to chop up one of the potatoes really fine. Let's put these guys into the bowl. Let's dump the water out of it. Put it into the bowl. We got 13 minutes to go. Our 40-minute timer, which is basically meaning that we've been cooking this thing for about an hour, right? just let it crackle, crackle. And this potato, I'm gonna cut it fine. Okay. Fairly fine anyway. Last 10 minutes hype. That's the timer. I just realized what you were saying. We still have to chop up the onions, so it gives us enough time to chop up onions. So this is how many potatoes we got. Yeah. That sound that you hear is the tap on our sink is, the thing is threaded so it falls off. I gotta fix it. And we need the onions. We're gonna cut up two onions. Okay. Usually I would just use yellow, but I ran out of yellow. I grabbed this one, and red is fine too. Okay, but usually it's cooking onion, the yellow one I end up using. Before we do this, let me take care of this guy first. I'm gonna get rid of the gook, the liquid gook. And this is how much gook we got out of it, right? Take a look. I don't know what you call this. Thank you. find this very meditative cooking. Hello, sir. I came late to the stream. What are we cooking? Okay. We're cooking borscht, sort of Russian style, Ukrainian style, Eastern European. Borscht is Eastern European. I think its origin is Russian. So we're cooking borscht, and we're my mom's recipe. Okay. And what I've done is wrote it down on stickies over the phone when I talked to her. Right? I've eaten this many times. I cooked versions of this, but I've never made full-on borscht, her recipe, before. So this is our first go at it. Okay. And we'll see how it comes out. I might adjust the recipe or keep it the same, right? And right now what we've done, we've got the meat cooking in there. We got a boiling. We need it for about an hour. Okay, preferably an hour in a pressure cooker, but or 2 hours in one of these, but I've kicked up the temperature pretty high. So in an hour should be good. Okay, but personally I would do it longer and a little bit lower temperature if we weren't doing this 3 hour stream. If it was like a 6 hour stream, 5 hour stream, slowly cook it. Right? What do we need? I need the chopped up onions to go into a bowl. So I'm gonna grab a bowl. Right? We'll put the chopped up onions in there. And we got a whole bunch of stuff chopped up already. Here, let me show you. Here's carrots, beets, and red and orange peppers that we've chopped up that we're gonna add into the borscht. We got tomatoes, right? Chopped up. We got potatoes, chopped up. Some fine, some bite size, right? We got white cabbage, chopped up and rinsed. Okay. We got bay leaves we're gonna add to the soup. And in another 10 minutes or so after I chop this up, we're gonna transfer the meat into this other pot that we have here, and then start layering what we've cut up. Let it cook for a bit with a little bit of broth for like 5-10 minutes, steam to a certain degree, 5-10-15 minutes. And then once it's steamed, then they look like they're starting to cook up, and then we're gonna add the broth to it, right? Just read the comments you were talking about. Beautiful story. Awesome, Eduardo. Thank you. It was... so there's a video I put out, Eduardo, just so you know. It's called Advice for Those Who Have Lost Loved Ones. And I learned a lot through that process and more, right? So some of those experiences that I had during that period, I am very glad that I made certain decisions the way I did. I obviously made some poor decisions as well, but I share the good ones, right? Brazil during the World Cup? Wow, man, that was fun. Brazilians, you guys know how to party. Really. I was stationed in San Francisco during that World Cup, and I went to bars that Brazilians were in. And Brazil was firing on all cylinders. They were a phenomenal team. Like, they were unstoppable, right? And it was just fun playing around, partying with the Brazilians and stuff. Okay. Driving from San Francisco to Los Angeles to see different games in different stadiums, because those are the two cities that I went and watched the games. On the highway in the U.S., people were very passionate about sports. And even though it wasn't really part of the mainstream, there's a lot of people that were loving the game. And people would have their flags hanging out of their cars, whichever country they were in. And I had the Brazilian flag hanging out of my trunk, and on the highway when I was driving from San Fran to Los Angeles or back and forward, Brazilian flag would be flying, and then there'd be German flags, and then this. So people were honking and cheering. It was a fun experience. Fun experience. And Americans, man, I was blown away by how well organized it was and how much love there was for soccer. How much love there was for soccer in the US, right? Especially since I was buying the tickets at like face value. Crazy. Who goes sees a World Cup final, Brazil, Italy, for face value of a ticket? Right? Check this out. I think I grabbed too small of a bowl. It's already filled up. Is that enough onions? No, I'm gonna chop this one up too. We're gonna make it the onions. Is that gonna be too much? Is that gonna be too much onions? Let's check it out. Let's see. We got that, we got that, we got that. Da-da-da, cabbage. I'm gonna chop up half of this. Okay. Half will be enough. And I need to put the other half in a container because onion takes on a lot of huge, takes on smells and stuff like this, and it gives out a fair bit of smell, so I don't want it to stink up the fridge. Okay, so we're gonna put this in the fridge. Oh, we're down to the last minute and a half. We did our chopping well. Here. Here, let's pile it up. Here's our onions. So, now I'll let the buzzer go so you hear it. So you know it's been 40 minutes, okay. I'm not gonna let it go too long. As soon as it goes beep, we're gonna knock it down. And then we're gonna kick this guy down, okay. And transfer the meat over to the pot and start layering the stuff. Let me do this though. Our timer. Let's put this guy here. So this is our broth right now. So it's got a nice color to it, okay, which is perfect. That's what we want, right? So it's cooked well. I can see a little bit of oiliness to it and stuff too, so that's not bad either. Okay. And the gook's sitting on the sides and the bottom, so we don't have too much gook. Okay. So I'm gonna put this guy over here. Nice. Now, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna dirty meat. I'm gonna add a little oil at the bottom so it doesn't, because the thing was hot, right? And don't really need it, but I'm gonna transfer over the meat. Just grab it. So I don't want it to stick to the bottom. Okay, here's this guy. All right, let's leave that at the bottom. Here are these guys. Put it here so you see. Okay, nicely cooked. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of broth. Just some, right now anyway. Yeah. Just to calm things down. Okay, I'm going to put this lid here. Let's leave this guy here for now. Okay, I'm going to transfer. We don't need this guy anymore. So this guy's done. Now what we're going to do is, I'm going to dump the onions on first. Actually, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the bay leaves on there first. Right? So I'm going to take music to my ears. Yeah, me too. Phenomenal. I love this stuff, man. I love it. So I'm going to take about 5 bay leaves. This is 4. I'm going to take a little bit more. That's 4. I'm going to take 6, 7. I like bay leaves. It gives it a nice aroma. Let's do 1 more. 8. Okay. That might be a little too much, but I want it to be strong. It's winter. Okay. I'm going to dump the onions in first. Okay. We're dumping all of the onions. So that was 1.5 large onions. Okay. Now we're going to dump cabbage. Cabbage, we're not going to dump all of it. It's just going to be too much. Dry it all up later. And this is gonna shrink, right? Our pot's like way too small. We got so much ingredients to add. So what I might do is check this out. We're gonna make 2. Maybe should I make 2? That's going overboard. That's just too much. That's just too much. 2 bowls? Should we make 2 bowls? 2 pots of soup? Should we make 2 pots of borscht? We don't have ingredients for it. I do need to transfer one of the meats, a couple of the meats over. Should we do? I think we should do. So, let's do an adjustment. Okay. I'll make an adjustment so you guys see what's going on once we get organized. Okay. Once we get organized. So we need to go down here. We need to grab a meat. What are we grabbing? We're grabbing a big one. Okay. So this guy, the big one, is gonna go in this one. Okay. Nice. Oh, we did add all the onions in here though. Oops. I'm gonna chop up the half onion and throw it in this. Okay. Let's see. Can we grab some from there? Oh yeah, we can grab some from there too. Let's do it. Mom would be going, "What are you doing?" Check this out. And we're gonna have to add the bay leaves in there too, right? It's got some onions in it, that's good. It is a fantastic sound. Take a look. Okay, let that sit there. And let me put this on the side. Let me take this broth. There. Let's transfer.
transfer this guy over.
Let's get rid of this guy. We're gonna use the next stovetop as well.
Let's put this guy here.
And we're game. Nice. I do need to chop off the other onion, right? So let me put the lid on this. What are we doing? Where's my lid for this?
Oh, here it is.
Let me put my lid on this for now. That way we're not worried about it. We'll get everything going at the same time to a certain degree. Right? We'll put a couple of bay leaves in this guy too. We got one out of that one. I'm going to kick up the temperature on this, start getting it heated up. Let's add three bay leaves. This is going to be smaller. But that way we get to use all our ingredients. Might invite over some friends to have some borscht. Right. I'm just gonna do this by hand, not a cutting board. Right? Don't try this at home unless you know your cutlery. Right? Knives. It should be finer than this, but we'll find out what the taste is like, right? Yes. And that's that.
Nice guy can go there. Give our hands a little wipe. Now we can add
cabbage on top of this. I'm gonna kick up the temperature on this a little bit. Now this guy is hot, this stovetop here. So I'm kicking up the temperature to about 5 right now. 5 out of 9. And that'll heat up fast, okay? So that's that. How's our situation here? That's good too. I'm gonna add a little bit more cabbage on top of this. And that one's good. So we ended up, there's a little bit of cabbage left there. So we ended up using about 3/4 of 1 cabbage. Okay. Got to go now, Chicho. Hope it turns out awesome. I hope so too, brother. I hope so too. Salutations from Canada to Brazil. Beets and peppers. Let's do this. Right. Beets and peppers. Beets, peppers, and carrots. So I'm gonna put some of the beets on first. Some of the peppers. Okay. And there's the carrots down there. We add all this stuff up. Hopefully we have enough broth to go around, right? You can hear this guy. Okay. So I'm gonna add a little broth to it. Potatoes. Okay. And we're going to add some tomatoes. Nice. Cool. Let's throw the lid on this guy. I'm gonna add more salt to it as well, but I'm gonna taste the broth first to see how salty the broth is. Okay, for this guy, potatoes, whatever's left.
Right. And we're gonna add the tomatoes.
Okay. We're not making two pots. two pots of borscht. Nice, I love it.
Now we're gonna let them simmer for a bit. Kick it up. I want steam to be cooking, right? So I'm gonna kick up the temperature on this one. Let's kick it up. I'm putting it to 5 on this one now. Okay. This one's at around 5 as well. I'm just getting it caught up with this one. Right? Nice. That's what we want. Let it cook a little bit. Nice. And the rest of this, other than, actually, I'm gonna put a timer of 10 minutes. Let it steam, right? And then I'm gonna taste the broth, and I'm gonna add broth to both of these, right? And if the broth is not salty enough, I'm gonna add more salt to it, okay? Almost 2 hours. We've got another hour and a half to do on this, right? So I might spend a little bit of time cleaning up. What I'm gonna do is taste the broth right now. Let's check it out. Let's see what the broth tastes like. Let's put it in. This is gonna be my tasting bowl. So try this. It's got a nice amount of salt, so I'm not gonna add any more salt until I add the broth, let it cook a bit, and then we'll decide. Let's add a little bit more liquid to this guy. Open the lid first. Steam coming on. This is nicely steaming. So let's do this. I hope we got enough broth. Let's let that go. We've got another 7 minutes to go on this. Okay. I'm gonna put the food stuff in the compost bin that we have cleaned up a little bit. Everything's looking good so far, though. I must admit, Angie Shaw. Hey, Andy. Hey, Andy. How are you doing? How's life? Just noticed you popped by. Yeah, it looks good. It smells really amazing. Right now, it smells fantastic. Right? I don't know if I have the quantity of ingredients that we have in the right proportions to give the same color and the same taste as my mom's recipe. Because my mom, you know, here's, let me read you what she told me to do with this, right?
what I wrote down. For me, I just did it, right? So, and by the way, you can add pepper. You should add pepper to the broth as well. But for me, I'm not using peppers right now. I'm staying away from peppers. I like black peppers. So the broth, the meat, according to mom's recipe, it should have peppers, but it doesn't. Okay. So beef steak, salt, big pot, water cover heat, mild, 2 hours. We did an hour higher temp, right? So we got one white cabbage, and we used about 3/4 of one, right? According to ingredients, 3 to 4 beets, which we ended up using 3 bigger ones, medium-sized ones. 3 to 4 carrots, we ended up using 6, okay? 1 to 2 onions, we ended up using 2 onions, 2 large onions. So the onions were a fair bit. Peppers, 1 to 2 peppers, we ended up using 1.5 peppers, a larger peppers, which is okay. Potatoes, 3 to 4, we ended up using, I forget how many we used, it was like 4 or 5, right? But they were smaller, they weren't the large potatoes, right? And then tomatoes, 2 to 3 tomatoes, we ended up using 6 tomatoes, I think, right? And the directions were, keep the bouillon, which we have, which is the broth that the meat cooks in, right? This is my first cooking live stream. I'll be able to catch up live. Ah, awesome, sweet Andy. Welcome to the first cooking live stream, your first cooking live stream. Hey, is that Russian or Armenian? Hey, no, Russian. Livia, how are you doing? How's life? Here, let me show you what the borscht looks like, Livia. So far, anyway. We got 2 bowls going, right? We got the ingredients cooking in this one, and cooking in this one, too. It's just starting to steam here. I'm gonna let it cook for another. It's starting to smell the way it's supposed to smell. Fantastic. I like it. Okay. And then what we're supposed to do, meat, onions, and then you got the bay leaves, bouillon, and the rest of it is what we ended up doing, right, in large part. So right now it's just a waiting game to a certain degree. In about 3 minutes, I'm gonna add bouillon to both. I wish I could read Russian. I think that's Russian. Lemon liqueur. I'm gonna pour myself some lemon liqueur. Some more lemon liqueur as soon as we add the broth to these. Okay. Nice. This is starting to steam a little bit more. This one's going hardcore. I'm gonna take this down a little. Okay. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna give it a little mix. Nice. The color's coming out. The smell is good. The smell is borscht. The smell, which is really the cabbage in large part, right? It is. It's nice. I can see more delicious bananas in the background. I like bananas. And bananas, I buy them and I wait until they get the spots on them. When they have spots on them, I like eating them then. Right, I don't like eating raw bananas too much. I don't even mind eating like squishy bananas, like when they come brown. I like bananas. I actually make my borscht completely vegan. Oh, you make it vegan? That's cool. You make it meat vegan. So what's the broth? The broth is a veggie broth, Olivia? I'm going to transfer these guys over. Let's see. Let's put this guy over here. And can you make banana bread? No, I've never made banana bread. I do have a recipe, my mom's recipe, but I've never made it. We might try. Let's break this here. Okay. We got 3 pots going. Good cook. Good cooking session. Let's put this guy here. So I'm slowly going to start adding broth to both. Okay. timer is a minute left, I'm turning it off. Let's bring this over. Yes, veggie broth out of potatoes and peppers. Cool. Enough because I can see the liquid in it right now, because all the veggies are going to break down, right? Be right back. All the veggies are going to break down, so it's going to be brothy. Okay, so I'm going to close that up. I'm kicking this down to 3. Okay, let's do it for this guy too. I'm just going to pour this one in. The rest of the broth goes here. Careful with this. Let's move this guy. Give it up this way so we see. Nice. Perfect. Kicking this one up to a 6. And this one is like going crazy. This stove, this one, oh, our screen's all fogged up. This pot, this stove top is very heavy, very high heat. Looks very good. Smells amazing. Smells fantastic. I want to get this one up curdling. So we're going to start letting it curdle. While that's doing its thing, I'm gonna do minor cleanup here. Okay. Let's do this. Things that we've got. So, oh, this one we need. This one we need. This one we need over here. This guy over here. This guy over here. This guy. Simple stuff actually. I'm just gonna fill up the back pot with hot water so it's easy to clean later. Let it soak a little bit. Let this steam go down. Take a look. Yeah, it smells good. It smells very good. I gotta put the rest of the cabbage away too, so I'm gonna try to find a container and throw the cabbage in there. After I pour myself a little bit of lemon liqueur. A little bit more. Okay. And I'm gonna eat one of the lemons. I'm gonna kick this one higher. Okay. And I'm gonna grab some ice. Thank you.
see the convection ice thing going up. Very cool, man. The physics of it. Crazy cool.
Look at that. I don't know if you can see it. See these guys? Neat. This one to Corporal. I'm kicking it up to high. I wish I had some of that lemon liqueur. Easy to make. Easy to make. Easy to make. That's delicious. Soda water. I'm gonna add some soda water on it. Is that soda water? I've seen the video 3 times, so I should know by now.
Lemon, sugar, vodka. Done.
Absolute is my favorite vodka as well. Oh, really? Yeah, I really like it. It just agrees with me, right? It just agrees with me. With soda water, amazing. I didn't really mention too much of how I end up drinking the liqueurs. I usually on the rocks. I just mentioned on the rocks or straight up. But with soda water and... with soda water is for the summertime, it's like so refreshing, so refreshing. And then with ice cream sometimes, super good. Oh, you're Swedish, that's right. Promoting this Swiss product, this sweet product, right? From what I understand, it's very clean. Absolutely, is very clean. Never tried it with soda water. Yeah. How do people drink vodka in Sweden? Is it usually on the rocks or is it mixed drinks and stuff? I'm usually vodka on the rocks. Nice. Look at this. That's looking good. That's looking good. This is curdling like this on 3 out of 9. Like, the temperature on it is so crazy high. It's weird. Oh, this is smelling good. This is smelling the way borscht should smell. And it needs to break down, right? So I'm gonna mix and very good. That's looking really good. That's looking really good. Okay, that's what it was. So now I'm gonna kick it down. Now I'm kicking it down to about 5. Okay. Which is good. That's it. Now it's a waiting game. We drink it like schnapps sometimes, but I think most people mix it with Red Bull and soft drinks. Oh, Red Bull, soft drinks. No, no, no. They're taking the total experience of the vodka away. Might as well just drink pop. Alcoholic pop, that's what they're drinking. No, no. I don't do Red Bull. I don't like it. I don't like the chemical feel of a Red Bull. I like my drinks to be pure. In my old age, I'm assuming it's more youth that are drinking the Red Bull because they're getting the kick and soft drinks and stuff. But for me, I stopped drinking soft drinks almost 20 years ago now. And I like the pure taste of, pure experience of whiskeys and vodkas and cognac. Every now and then I mix certain drinks together. Like one drink that I love is called a Beautiful. Okay, I don't drink it often because it's very high sugars, a lot, right? But it's Grand Marnier and cognac, 50-50. I have it neat, but I'm more into whiskey. Yeah, neat I like too. Neat with vodka, cold. With whiskey for sure. On the rocks or it's neat. I don't mix anything with my whiskeys. Sometimes soda maybe, but I don't think so though. I don't remember mixing soda with my whiskey. With vodka I do. Vodka, the only other way that I drink the vodka is lemon, a little bit of lemon and soda water. Sometimes just a little coloring of cranberry. Very little. Sometimes, rare. Once or twice a year. The rest of it is on the rocks or neat. Same time. Look at that. That's what we're talking about. Do we have tomatoes in this one? Yeah, we did. Oh, we just mixed that one up. This is tomatoes on top, right? Very good. Very good. I'm going to give this one a mix. I'm going to give it a little bit of a... Holy macaroni. Fun. I didn't plan on making two pots. This is gonna take us 3 days to eat, right? That one might end up just freezing. Or we might call some friends. Actually, we have a friend coming over this weekend, so there's gonna be three of us eating. Well, today's what? Today's Tuesday. It's not gonna last until... can't keep it until the weekend. Might invite some friends over to have some borscht. If it tastes good. I haven't tasted it yet. We gotta make sure it tastes good. I could taste it right now. Let's do it. Let's taste a little bit of this. It's not gonna be the full flavor yet, for sure. But we can get an idea of what the broth is like. I just want to taste it just to see if it needs any salt. If we're down the right path anyway. I'm glad we made two bowls though. I had too many ingredients for one bowl. You end up making so much. I just cut things up. Cut up. I should have reduced the number of potatoes, the number of carrots. Yeah. And the cabbage, borscht is cabbage, so cabbage I'm good with. Soup to be looking good, yeah. Oh yeah, it definitely has my mom's borscht flavor to it.
Fantastic. I'm very happy.
Very happy. Making mom proud here. But it has to simmer. It has to simmer for. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, let it up and go. I have never had borscht. Can you describe the flavor? It's, oh man, how do you describe the flavor of borscht? How do you describe the flavor of borscht? It's got a very wintry taste to it. It's heavy, right? It's you can taste the root vegetables, right? You can taste the heaviness of the root vegetables. Very umami, spicy. It's borscht flavor. It's borscht flavored. It's for me, I haven't added any pepper, so spicy is not sharp for me. You should add peppers. The meat fat gets into the for this, if you're not making vegan, if you're using meat, gets into the flavors of the root vegetables. You can definitely taste the cabbage. The cabbage has a very unique flavor to it, right? So there's a cabbage overtone to it, undertone to it, I guess. But you can definitely taste, like, there's carrot flavor, borscht flavor, borscht. Yeah, it's very unique. When you're eating it, I'll make a bowl. We'll let this cook for a little bit longer, a little bit longer, at least half an hour longer. We'll chit chat, right? We're gonna go until 3. So, in about 45 minutes or so, what I'll probably end up doing is pouring a bowl, and we're gonna add some greens on top, okay? Some parsley cilantro mix that I have, and then you can. Usually, you have a bowl of borscht, and then you have a side little plate where if you have meats, you can take the meat out, or you put bread in it. You can dunk the rye bread in it. Sometimes you have flat bread, you take the meat, eat it, you know, wrap it up, make a wrap, and eat it with the flat bread. The meat with some greens in there is fantastic, right? And a lot of the times, if you got the if you've done it, you make gyroshki, which is sort of deep fried sort of dumplings that have either potatoes in them or meat, sort of a hamburger style with eggs and onions and stuff. It's very good. I need to find a place that sells it, or fly over. You're welcome if you can make it here. I got a lot here, right? It's rare that I've had borscht in restaurants that is as good as home cook meals, home cook borscht. We should do a live stream cooking collab on YouTube. Oh, we could. We could decide on something to make and make it. Yeah, that'd be cool. That'd be super cool. I'll have to, you know, we'll have to put the ingredients together so everyone gets the same ingredients and we end up making it. That'd be fantastic, Olivia. Good idea. We do. If we haven't done it in a couple of months, remind us and we do. For sure, for sure. That'll be super fun. We could start with something simple as well. We could make pancakes. Talk about, start talking about philosophy and make pancakes. The lids of these things are getting hot, right? So, put a little cloth there. Could change the camera angle so you can see the borscht better. last month before. I think so. Yeah. Yeah. In my life, I've tried a few different things. Pancakes and falafel. That bit is how I found your channel. Was it? Jesus, nice. I think that was like the third cooking live stream we did. That was super fun. We do again. We do again. For sure, we do again. Lately, I've been making gluten-free pancakes. I just did pancakes like 3 days ago. Fantastic. And yeah, I was using tapioca pudding. And tapioca pudding is like gooey. So, blueberry gooey pancakes. Super delicious. It's also one of my favorite. Is it the Bellini one? Condensed milk is... Oh, condensed milk. I don't know what... Well, it's the sugar, I'm guessing. But condensed milk is... just delicious. If you like condensed milk, Olivia, you should also try Vietnamese coffee. I think it's called Vietnamese coffee. The coffee with condensed milk with ice, and you mix it all up. It tastes amazing. The temperature on this guy is on 2.5 out of 9. Take a look at this thing. It's just going crazy. Kicking it down to like 2. Speaking of pancakes, it is Pancakes Tuesday in Israel. In Ireland, is it? On Tuesdays, you guys have pancakes? Is that like a thing? It is a great video. And also, damn, Pancakes Tuesday. Pancakes Tuesday. Happy Pancakes Day, guys. Awesome, Olivia. That's true. Happy pancakes. If I knew, we would have made pancakes today too. Well, we couldn't have done both. We could have scheduled the borscht on another day. Oh, this one is looking phenomenal. Look at that. This one's got good liquid in it. Alright? This one's lacking a little liquid. Yeah, this one's looking fantastic. Nice. We leave this one alone. How's this one doing? This one's lacking a little liquid, but let me see. What I could do is cut up another tomato and throw it in there. Let's throw the last tomato we have in here. Because tomato is liquidy, it will increase the liquid content. Just cut up the end of the tomato. I've already washed this, right? And I put it in the plate so it's all clean. And let's do this. I'm just gonna mix it up with this guy a little bit. I think I was originally supposed to be a marketer for the Catholic holiday, but it got the Christmas treatment, and now really is just a holiday just because it's fun. Cool. Like, it's actually a holiday in Ireland. Pancake Tuesday. Can't deny the joy in pancakes. Absolutely, absolutely agree. Nice. cabbage needs a while to break down and cook, right? So this is good like this. Looking good, looking good. And you can tell with the carrots, right? The carrots are like full on stuff. So this needs to simmer a fair bit. For me, it's Tekken Tuesday. Is it Tekken Tuesday with Chicho's stream in the background? Awesome, you're playing. Nice. Pancake is greater than Tekken. I don't know, it depends how much you love Tekken. This guy needs more liquid. This guy needs more liquid. What can we add to this to increase the liquid without diluting it? We can have more cabbages. Cabbages give out liquid. Could you tell me what it is? Tekken. Tekken, I believe, is a game. Tekken is also an anime. There is an anime, Tekken, as well, I believe. But I think it all originated from the game. Fighting game, yeah. Yeah. Tekken, I think in Japanese, it must mean something, because I've seen anime where, for example, there's an animation and manga called Tekken Kirikirin, something like this. Amazing manga, amazing animation. But Tekken must mean fight or battle or something. It's this great dish made from NES cartridges. Awesome. Was it NES? Tekken came out with the NES system? Is that old, eh? That's cool. I mostly practice combos in training mode and hang out on streams. Cool. Ah, I see. Tekken is this game in which you fight against pancakes. Killer pancakes. I shoot blueberries at you. Fun. For real, not, no. No, Luca. And he's just having fun. I didn't realize it was from the NES system. There's so many games that came out in the 80s, 90s that have had huge lasting power that they're still around. Sonic, Mario, Firefox, what are they? Jeez, there's so many of them. Tetris, so many games that have lasted. And they will be with us forever, really. Nope, just Googled it. Arcade then? It was arcade. Okay. The first Tekken was Dreamcast, I think. Zelda. Oh, Zelda. Of course, Zelda. Zelda. I wish one game that... I'll show you guys during our gaming, video gaming collection, when I end up putting it together. Tetris. I know that. Yes, you do. You're Russian, Olivia. One of the greatest games ever. And the best Tetris game I've ever played. And if you love Tetris, I'm going to do a plug here. Is N64 New Tetris. It came out for the Nintendo 64 New Tetris. Brilliant. The greatest Tetris game I've ever played. They also had like a 3D Tetris, but the New Tetris on Nintendo 64 was absolutely brilliant. I spent hours upon hours upon hours upon hours playing that game. Zelda is great. Oceania of Time. Oh yeah, would be nice, Chicho. Tetris is super relaxing, super relaxing. And with the new Tetris, you can make super blocks that are either silver or gold. And the gold ones are the ones that are made from the same shape, and the silver ones are the ones that are made from different shapes together that are square as well, and they zap up and you can battle each other and stuff. One of the greatest games ever. The new Tetris, one of the greatest games. And there's a comic book, graphic novel out. The same people that made the Andy Kaufman one and Andre the Giant one, and they make bibliographies and stuff like this. And I've heard it's amazing. So there's a graphic novel out of how Tetris came to be. I still haven't got it, but it's on my radar to get. It's one of the books that I want to read, the origin of Tetris and how it came to be and stuff like this. I knew a little bit about it in the past. I can't remember what happened with the person that made it. Just watch the documentary on the making of Tetris. It's so sad knowing that the creator Alexander basically got nothing. Yeah, that's what it was. Got nothing, and that it was like a virus crippling the productivity of important Russian computers. Really? Because everyone got distracted. Seriously, it's like welcome to our world now. Everyone's playing games and stuff, right? I'm gonna take down my apron. I've already cut up everything. Now it's eating time. Well, not right now, but in a half an hour, what are we at? We're gonna take a look at this stuff. The cabbage has to break down. Oh, this is looking good. This is looking good. And the meat has to be nicely broken now. This isn't yet. Oh, it's getting there. Still needs to cook. Still needs to cook for a while. But we'll definitely give it a taste. Oh, this meat is good. See it breaking down? That's what you want. Just coming off the bone, and there's bone marrow in there now. Sorry to those who don't like the meat. So, Livia, I hope this isn't turning you off of borscht or meat. I could give you guys some info on the Tetris theme song if you like. We'd love it. What's the info, Livia? But only if you like, please. One of the things I love about streams and creating this content and these videos and stuff like this is because people that know things, they post comments or on the live streams, they come and give us history about something that we've been talking about, which is brilliant, which is brilliant. Right? We learned something on the last stream about System of a Down, and there was a fair bit of System of a Down conversation, so there's a fair bit of talk on that. So yes, please, the music of Tetris. Too easy to drink. Too easy to drink. Time to drink some tea. Everyone's in a holding pattern waiting for a Tetris music story. So the theme song is called Koro Benki, System of Down Lore, last stream. Tetris Lore, the stream. Yeah. Love it. Heaven. Bliss. Life is good. Life is good. Korobiniki. I'm gonna put on my glasses so I can read this properly. Korobiniki. And it is about people riding around with their bikes and selling things. Really? 99. I don't think I've seen Tetris 99. Tetris Battle Royale. I don't think I've played that Tetris Battle Royale. Maybe I have. When did it come out? And it's about people riding around with their bikes and selling things. That's what the theme song is about. Russian theme song about riding around on a bike and selling things used for Tetris. That's cool. It must be. Is it an old song, Olivia? Nice. there is a selling situation between two people on the song, I believe. But I'll give you more info on Discord because I really don't want to leave the stream. Okay, yeah. Don't leave the stream, Livia. Yeah, on Discord for sure. People have been posting, following up on Discord, which is fantastic, right? Tetris 99 is very recent, and you compete for spaces with other players. 99 people to be exact. Oh, wow. So you're working on the same space, land coming down, and you can zoom across at the same time? It is very old. The song is very old, yeah? For Tetris, that's cool. I gotta look into the history of that too. Yeah, but post it on Discord, Livia, for sure. I would love to read it. What was the name of the Russian choir CDs you have? Oh, it was, I saw in your new video. It was, I grabbed those CDs. I believe I grabbed those CDs in the 90s when we went to the Russian ensemble, Russian Army ensemble was doing a tour in the 90s or late 80s around the world, and they came to Vancouver and they were playing in a auditorium. And man, the Russian Army choir ensemble singing was amazing. It was a chorus. I stood up. There was one part where I stood up, and I was the first person standing up when they were done. Stood up and started clapping my hands. It was amazing. They had one guy on there that would do whistle, and his whistle was just like rhythmic, beating with the sound, and it echoed through the whole auditorium. It was brilliant, really. I forget what it's called. It was a Russian Army ensemble something. Alexov Choir. Was that what it was? Alexov Choir? Kind of. It's hard to explain, but you share screens with clusters of players. Oh, this is a Tetris. And they invade your board to sabotage. Oh my god, that sounds amazing. So you gotta be quick on the down button, right? As soon as you see something coming, you gotta pound it down. Otherwise, someone else is gonna take it. That's cool. Stressful. I found Tetris when I'm playing it to be relaxing. Tetris 99 sounds stressful. Every time you get a line, you can send it to someone to sabotage them. Oh no! I didn't know that. Thanks for the info. Oh wow. Crazy. You can send the lines. Jinx, you didn't know that. Or Jink, you didn't know that. Oh yeah, I love them too, despite not being an authentic Russian. I'm not an, well, I guess I have Russian blood. My grandfather, great-grandfather was born in Russia, I guess. He spoke Russian. My grandmother spoke a little bit. And Armenian and Russian, we've been brothers and sisters forever, right? So. This is looking good. Looking very good, very good, very good. So this one has the shank meat. And this one was the, look at this one. Very nice. And this one had the ribs, right? Looks delicious. I've played it much. It's free though on the Switch. Switch? You mean Twitch? Or Switch? I don't know what the Switch is. I haven't played online games for a while now. Or games for a while now. Gotta find time to zone out on some games. Super fun to do. Oh, the Nintendo Switch. Oh, wow. So as long as you have the Nintendo Switch, you can play on it. Nintendo Switch. Imagine a portable Wii. Yeah, I had students that bought the Nintendo Switch, and it looked really cool. He showed it to me. One of my students, anyway, he showed it to me. He liked it. Yeah. And you can take off the handles and do things, or you can put it on the handles, or you can transfer it over. It was cool. It was sort of Tetris-y, I guess, put together. He liked it. He liked playing it. But it's. I haven't seen any of my other students going off on it as much as that one student I had last year. I think he came out last year, a year before. So I don't know how much of a hype, how much the hype lasted, if people really were into it. Still has this selling. I think I had a Nintendo. I still have Nintendos. They're in boxes. I'm gonna try a little bit more. Let's try a little bit more. It's a portable Zelda machine for me, so I love it. Portable Zelda machine. It was blue, and I had a game in which I owned a boutique. That was the Nintendo game you had? You owned a boutique. Which game would that be? The gamers here must know. Take a look. Nice color to it. Beautiful color to it. Really. Very nice color. Take a look. Smells fantastic. Tasting good. Tastes better than the first time, so selling it. I just realized something. I have never not meet a really nice, friendly, and smart person from Armenia. You haven't met enough. There's always every. Well, thank you for the compliment. But everybody has their good and bad. Everybody has their good and bad. We are all the same. We are all the same. This is very good. I'm getting there. Getting there. I'll make a bowl after I taste that one. I'm gonna see which one tastes better, and we're gonna make a bowl. I'm gonna show you how we end up eating it. I have recently watched a documentary about Armenia, and I was not able to take my eyes off the screen. Which documentary, Olivia? Two sides to every coin. Two sides to every coin. Fantastic. Mom would be proud. Mom would be proud. So many landscapes, so much things. Yeah, Armenia is rugged as well. Mountainous and lakes and hard, rugged terrain makes for well-adapted people, hard people. We're on the hard side, I think. Delicious. Wish I could send you guys a bowl each. There was a French documentary, I believe. Ah, cool. Yeah, there's a lot of French, a lot of Armenians living in France, Paris. Like France, I think, was one of the first EU countries, European countries, to recognize the Armenian genocide. Try this one now. Last weekend, I took the subway. In the opposite sat a 50-year-old man playing with a Nintendo Switch. The next station, an 11-year-old boy came in and sat next to him. next to him, playing with a Game Boy Color. It was a very nice scene. Oh, it would have been amazing, man. For sure. For sure. If people want, the divide between generations doesn't exist. But propaganda, corporate government propaganda, puts that division between all of us, right? Programming we need to break. It's a shame that the U.S. doesn't recognize the genocide for military supply reasons. Yeah, they need the arms relations, apparently. Damn shame. Damn shame. Damn shame. There's a few countries that don't recognize it. And all of them is because of political reasons. Let's try this one. Let's take a little bit of meat as well. Borscht meat, you want it to be really falling apart on you, right? So this still needs to cook. But we can definitely try it. Let's check out this one. This was cooking harder than this one at first, right? So the flavor of this one is stronger and the meat's falling apart. So we're gonna have a sample of this one. Very good. And the tomatoes are totally breaking down. Delicious. Very good, very good. Sorry guys, but I have to sleep now. Bye to all of you. Good night Andy. Hope you have a fantastic, fantastic sleep, fantastic dreams. Rest well. Thanks for sticking around. Thank you for sticking around, for sure. Very good. Very good. The meat is really good as well. Let's all dream of borscht. Very good. Delicious, delicious. We'll let it simmer for another 10 minutes or so. And then I'm going to show you what we end up doing. Right? I'm going to cut up some bread. I think the generation divide is to make it easier to market and keep dying industry around. Yeah, you're young, you must have an iPhone and complain about old people, or you're old so you must complain about iPhones and instead buy newspapers. Yeah, and just and it goes, it's age and sex and clothing. It's just compartmentalizing everyone, right? One of the first things I mentioned during the personal finance videos that I made, and I've mentioned it before in economics, politics, and personal finance, and other things as well, is we should all have friends from all across the board. I know people who only hang around, like if they're in their 20s, they only hang around people in their 20s, 30s, 30s, 40s, 40s, 50s, 50s, you know, teenagers. We should all have friends from all of the different, as many categories of people as we can, because as soon as you have friends from all those categories, your eyes open up. Like how are young people in their teens, 20s, 30s supposed to prepare for what's coming when you're older if they don't have older friends? Age doesn't exist. Experiences exist, right? Wisdom there's one thing that says wisdom comes with age, but I think wisdom comes with experiences and the way you've lived your life, right? So it's weird. To me, it's weird. To me, it's very weird. I'm going to cut up the bread. I'm going to show you what this bread looks like. I'm going to bring out a plate. This is like deep rye bread, right? A little bit of seeds in it. And this is amazing with borscht. Wisdom also comes with observation, yeah.
What put do you have?
Learning from, one thing I figured out pretty early on was if I only learn from my mistakes, I'll become intelligent, wiser over time. If I learn from other people's mistakes, that accelerates. I become wiser faster. Right? Yes. Just cut up two slices. Seeds on it. Delicious. Should we pour ourselves some borscht? Yeah. We're going to sample this one. It's the same as this one. But I'm going to let them simmer. Sour cream.
Okay.
Oh, it's less light back there now. So we leave the door open. Lots of plants in the back. Oh, goodness. Before I do the borscht, one of my plants is needs water. The leaves are down. If you don't have a limit to your types of friends, you don't have limits to how much knowledge you can gain. Yeah. Do you also put smetana into your borscht? Cream fraiche. I put sour cream. Smetana. I eat it. I usually eat it with yogurt. I love it with yogurt. I also love it with sour cream. Sour cream we put less in. Yogurt more in. Just on the side and just eat a little bit with it, mix it in there. So I think that's what you mean. Sour cream in traditional whoopee, sour cream with borscht is amazing, right? It's so good. Yogurt is very good too. Nice. I'm gonna kick this down a little bit. That was sitting at 2, cooking, boiling away, right? I'm putting it 1 out of 9 now, and this one I'm kicking down to 1 out of 9. The rest of it needs to be simmered, right? So put this guy here. Let's pour ourselves some borscht. Looking good. I'll take a little. Well, the meat we'll add later at the top. Alright. I'm gonna add some of the juices. Very good. I'm gonna grab a chunk of the meat. Yeah, we'll grab a smaller chunk. A little bit more. bowl's gonna be hot, right? So take a look. So we got the borscht in there. Enough liquid to leave some of the stuff exposed, right? What I wanna do, I got greens all chopped up here. Okay. Now this is, usually it's just cilantro or parsley and stuff. This is Italian parsley, cilantro, and regular parsley. So I'm gonna take some of this and put it on top, right? Let's put it here and show you guys. So take a handful of this, right? And just sprinkle on top. You don't need to make it too much, but just enough, right? Here, I'll show it to you this way. Take a look. Right? Okay. And a spoonful of sour cream. Crack this open. I bought the sour cream specifically for today. Don't go, you know, I like enough sour cream to give it a nice flavor, right? Sour cream. And you can take your bread, right? Put it on the side. And this is the way we would serve. Take a look. You got the sour cream on the side here. Take a look. Let me put this here so you see, right? So we got the sour cream, the greens, you got the meat here, right? And you got your bread that just sucks in the juices. And usually on the side, I've already set it up, got mustard, okay? Mustard that with the meat, you can just have a fork on the side, you dip the meat in it and eat it with mustards and drink up the soup and eat the soup, right? That looks very nice. Yeah. Hello, my friend. Hello, Zuplex. How are you doing? Welcome to a cooking live stream towards the end of it. Take a look. Delicious. The meat can cook a little bit more because you do want it to sort of break apart, right? But what I'm going to do, I'm going to dip it into the mustard. Right. Mustardy, I like mustard in this thing, right? Very delicious. Very delicious. And then mix it all up. You can grab some of the sour cream and just mix it into the soup, right? And then with a spoonful, just eat it up, right? And it didn't need any more salt. Super good, super good. And with the bread. And the bread, you don't need to put in the bowl. You can just have on the side where the garlic is, and you can take chunks of the meat out, put them on the side plate. And then every now and then just dip the bread in the soup and just eat it up, right? Super delicious. To make this more Russian, I'll recommend some black tea in the end. Okay. I've had tea going the whole time we've been we've been streaming, right? I have tea going always. Always. There you are. Nice.
toast.
Nice. With a little bit of the greens. Well, I officially now know how to make old school borscht. Balia, hello, I hear you're Persian and I live in Canada. I am also Persian living in Canada. I was just wondering what part of Iran you are born in. If you were born in Iran, that is. Yeah, I was. I was born in Tehran, but I lived in the south, Khuzestan. Very good. This one needed a little bit more liquid. Give it a shake. Let it simmer. And this one, it's got lots of good liquid. Okay. So next time I would probably add a little bit more water to it, to things. Okay. At the beginning, when we're doing the cooking up the meat. The salt content I would keep the same. Mm-hmm. Very good. Very happy with it. Here's my fork. I'm gonna dip the meat in. I hope you guys are having good food. The essence of life is good food. Oh, lots of mustard on this one. Nice. My mother was also born in Tehran. I was born in Canada though. Uh-huh. I showed her your channel and she loved it. Salam alaikum. Send her my best. Send her my best. Very delicious. That's a nice spoonful of borscht with a little bit of sour cream in there with the greens and stuff. Very good. Super delicious. This looks like it would be perfect with Irish soda bread. Oh, really? Irish soda bread? With sourdough, it's amazing too. This borscht. I love it with sourdough. Whoa. You're still streaming. How was it? It tastes fantastic, Intrepid. Tastes really good. Mm-hmm. Take a look. Sour cream. We got meat, right? And then the borscht, and we put fresh greens on there. Like I got a whole bunch of fresh greens cut up, right? I cut all this up yesterday because I knew I was going to make borscht. That was gonna we're going to be eating for 3 days. So we're going to go through. I highly recommend. Include fresh herbs, fresh greens in your diet. One of the most important things you can do in regards to health is eat fresh cut greens raw, not necessarily cooked. Okay, just like this in soups, just by itself, just roll it up in a bun or something, just eat it. It'll improve your health. It'll keep you healthy for the long run, and you'll get a lot of minerals and stuff from it. It's really important. Very good. And then you take the sour cream, mix it in with the soup, all right? Get it going, or yogurt. Okay, yogurt is fantastic. Very delicious. It was worth the wait, gang. Looks good. Yeah, absolutely agree on the greens. 100%. Like, I go through a tremendous amount of greens and fruits. Fruits as well. I love fruits, but greens 100%. Just raw.
looks great. Phenomenal. Phenomenal.
Very good. I hope you guys...
X, how are you doing? Are you still here?
Eat well, eat well. More meat with mustard. I put spinach and kale in my smoothie each morning. It's highly recommended. Yeah. Spinaches. Kale is powerful. But you gotta, it's not raw kale. You gotta cook it up a little bit, no? Or you're putting raw kale in there, huh? I love your streams. They're just so wholesome. Fun. What about what's important in life? Food, conversation, drink. Well, we finished our lemon liqueur, so we're not going to have any more of that. But we do have black tea.
So nice to end my day with this live stream. Nice.
Yeah, raw kale. I just wash it. No stems. That's right. Okay, good, good. The stems need some serious cooking too. For your tummy to like them. Your tummy might be upset if you feed them raw stems of kale. And then what happens, slowly as you eat, the sour cream sort of breaks in there and gives it sort of a whitish tint, right? This is true winter food. It's amazing. Power food.
This is the best pancake Tuesday I've had in a very long while. Awesome, Jake. I'm glad.
Thank you for the follows and any subs that came on during the stream if I was distracted. So thank you for those. I hope you enjoyed the stream and enjoy your stay here. And borscht? One of the things with borscht is you eat one bowl and you're like, oh, that was good, very good. About 45 minutes, you're like, more borscht. You eat another bowl. And then another hour later, more borscht, and you eat another bowl. So with borscht, when you make it, you end up having borscht all day. Multiple bowls. For a couple of days, you do this, and then after a couple of days, you're like, okay, I'm borscht out, right? But you've got a lot of nutrients, a lot of amazing vitamins and fantastic flavor, right? This is the bread. Take a look. It's got all the juices on it.
Fantastic.
Very good, very good. So, first Tuesday of every month? No. It must be first Tuesday in March is Pancake Tuesday, right? Jink or jink? I don't know, there's no end there. It's addictive indeed. Addictive is the right word. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. Very good. Still curcumin. I think I need to kick this one off. I want to curcum a little bit more. Do I? first Tuesday in March is Pancake Tuesday. I think that should be a worldwide event. I'd sign a petition for it. And when you're eating it, you get runny nose every now and then. Another little piece of meat, dip it in the mustard, right? Amazing flavors. Shank phenomenal. So good. So tasty. I'm gonna save some and take some to my mom. Yes. World peace brings with international pancakes. Begins with International Pancake Tuesday. Yes. Oh my, the runny nose is always there when you cook borscht. Yeah. I don't know what it is. I don't know. Maybe because it's hot, you eat it, steam going. I don't know. It's just, your body just loves it, just exuberant. Fun. That was fantastic, gang. And I'm glad it came out okay. I would have been sort of disappointed if it didn't work out well. We made two pots of borscht that wasn't very good. This was very good. Nice. Look at this thing. So it took us 3 hours to make two huge pots of borscht. This one needed a little bit more liquid. Okay, look at the bone. Oh, it's got the marrow's gone out of it. Look at that, the marrow. Oh, that would be amazing. Okay, put that there. And we got our greens. So probably in another half an hour, I'm gonna have another bowl. Right. Awesome. And the sourdough or the rye bread is just fantastic on its own, right? Just to finish things off. And as Livia would say, and some black tea. Midnight here now. Gonna hit the sack. Thanks for the awesome stream, Chicho. We'll definitely make borscht soon. Awesome. Glad to be here, brother. Hope you have fantastic dreams. And we're probably going to end it now. 3 hours. 3 o'clock. Fantastic. Our timing worked out okay. So that's good. That's very good. Thanks for being here, gang. I hope you enjoyed. You could have mixed the lemon liqueur and the tea. You could have, I guess. It would taste good. But in tea, I just like lemon. Oh, yeah. By the way, on the borscht, I had lemon cut up too. Some people like it with lemon, squeezed lemon. For me, I do with and without. It depending if I want lemon in there or whatnot. But with tea, I like just fresh squeezed lemon in the tea, not the lemon liqueur. I don't think I even tried the lemon liqueur with the tea. I'll give it a shot. Maybe we'll do a little bit right now. Let's check it out. Why not? We have the lemon liqueur. We have the tea. I'm going to reduce the tea a little bit. Let's add a little lemon liqueur in there. See what it's like. This one stays by the counter. Thank you. Bye. Goodbye, Livia. Thank you for being here. Not bad. Fresh lemons squeeze better. Evil on toast. Thanks, Chicho. I have fun eating 20-ish bowl of bars. Thanks, I will. I think by the 20th, I'm going to go enough is enough. Happy Pancake Tuesday as well. May we all celebrate Pancake Tuesday someday in our lives. Okay. And aside from that, I'll try to set up a live stream maybe later this week. I'm not sure. I got some videos to shoot, comic book videos. I'm going to upload a video today, most likely, and take care of some stuff in the background. So we'll see what happens, but I'll try to get something in maybe in the next week. If not, it's going to be 10, 12 days from now or so. Okay. Sweet dreams if you're going to sleep. Good morning if you're waking up. And happy eating if you're eating heavy lunch or whatnot. Okay. Bye for now again. Another look. Let me put it down. Another look at the borscht. The borscht still curdling away. This one's starting to curdle again. Good, 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 good. Take care, everyone. Enjoy the rest of Pancake Tuesday. Bye for now.